Once again, okay, hello again to everybody on live stream as well. You're with Indians Wear Moccasins this afternoon. How's that? How you guys doing today? Gotta get on mic and talk to me here.
Hey, man, how you doing?
There we go. Life is good, guys. Hey, can somebody shut that door behind us here? First things first, we're going to go around the room and introduce everybody. What we're going to do is see if I have everybody's names down. Okay.
You're bad at that.
Cody.
Yep.
Kyle.
Yep.
Cameron. Dean. Eight. Nick.
Yep.
Or Bellbottoms.
Winner! Sebastian is not here with us today, everybody. We say hi to Sebastian anyway.
Have fun with your birthday festivities, man.
Oh, today is his birthday?
No, it was yesterday.
Yesterday? Okay. So first things first, I want to get a little bit of a history on the band. Cody, I understand that you're the one who started the band. So number one, where does the name Indians Wear Moccasins come from? And number two, how did you meet these four clowns? I mean, people.
Well, basically what happened was this band started back in about 2013, and it was under the name April in Chernobyl. And we did like this deathcore weird kind of thing. It was destined for failure. And a bunch of bad things happened. And we got this big fight over the name. And this dude wanted to take me to court over a band name. So I was like, whatever, dude. And we ended up, you know, kind of clashing together. And we were thinking of a name. And I had Indians Wear Moccasins stored in the back of my head because my senior year, I don't think I could talk about specific things,
okay.
But I was at school.
Not necessarily sober.
Yeah.
Okay.
But
okay.
You were there, but you weren't.
Yeah, exactly. Lights were on, but no one was home.
Quite there.
But anyways, we were watching a documentary on Indians, and I just they said the shoes they wore were called moccasins, and I thought it was the funniest thing for some reason.
Okay.
So I was just like, that could be a band name. So then, you know, boom, Indians Wear Moccasins came about.
There you go. And how did you meet these four? We'll start with Kyle, actually.
I've been friends with Kyle since, we were like four or five.
Oh, wow. Okay.
He's lived behind me for years. And Kid Marley, that's his rap name. He used to be a rapper till he came into the band, yeah.
Yeah, I just want to take a second to just appreciate how you can go from being a rapper to a synth player to a melodic death metal band.
Wait. Yeah. I got this. Hold on 1 second. Wait for it.
If he drops a beat, I'm going to lose it.
There you go.
I thought for sure we were going to drop a beat and he's going to freestyle.
No, I don't freestyle. It's not me, of course. So how'd you meet Cameron, then?
Cameron was actually through Bell Bottoms.
Okay.
Yep. We were...
There's a funny story there.
Well, you know, really quick to like the history of the band, it's kind of all... coincides with how everybody met is the original band, you know, Nick was on drums, I was on guitar, and we had we just call him simply Rudder on vocals, Sebastian was on guitar, and then Russell, our other buddy, was on bass. We did this this god awful pop punk metalcore thing. Me and Nick hated it. We wanted to get heavier and we kept trying to push it, but you know, nothing happened. And that's actually how we met Dion for the first time, was okay. His other band, Sentinel, was playing at a show we played at. And I just remember hearing him tell us how he was pretty much making fun of us as we were on stage.
Sorry.
you actually did dog Rudder on stage.
Well, the best part happened was when we were done, you know, Sentinel goes on, and I'm just in shock watching these guys, and I'm like, I just remember looking at Nick, and I'm just like, that's what I want to do. That's the music I want to play. I want to get out of this scene that's over flooding where we're from. You know, pop punk and metalcore is everywhere, and there's only so much you can do until you start sounding like everybody else. So... we decided, like, everybody quit the band except for me and Nick. Like, everybody just left because they did not want to be heavier. And then, you know, me and Nick had nowhere to go.
Sure.
And Andrew.
Oh, jeez.
I don't really want to talk about what happened with him, but it was bad. We went back to this deathcore kind of thing. It sucked. And we kicked him out, and he found... Cameron. He knew Cameron from an earlier band from like way back when. And he showed up, didn't even know what melodic death metal was. We were just like, we're going to go for it.
I wouldn't even consider what me and him did was even like a band.
No, we just kind of hung out and that's about it.
Played, like, tried to attempt to play music in a basement. And okay. It didn't even go anywhere.
Music, you know.
It wasn't that great.
We bring Cameron in and he has no clue what we're even talking when we say melodic death metal.
Because I'm from more of a Parkway Drive, Bullet for My Valentine with a lot of Tool influence.
Oh, okay.
And then coming here is like, I have no idea what this even is.
Yeah, and he comes into a band where, you know, my main influence is bands like Children of Bodom and In Flames and Thy Antichrist and stuff like that. You know, just getting into the real European death and black metal side of things. And we ended up just kind of, I showed him like an example, and the next day he's over there just got riffs all for it. And I'm like, dude, this kid's staying.
Should we hear an example of one of these riffs real quick?
Well.
Yeah, sure.
Cameron? Let's hear it real quick. I'm using this as the tuning session for the guitarist for the board. So
that works for me.
Sounds good to me.
Crispy Pickens.
Let's see. You want to just go to the second part of the revenge?
All right. Should I scream?
Go ahead. You can, but I need to be prepared on the mic. So, go for it.
I'll just do a four count on the guitar.
All right, I'm gonna scream at you guys real quick. Are you ready for this?
I'm scared.
All right. Well, I'm gonna scream.
Forward in our days, forward in faith.
We are the warriors along your sea.
We face it of our eyes.
You know, I think I've interviewed 4, 5, 6, 7, whatever number bands on the air here. Dean, you're the first screamer that I've ever interviewed.
Thank you.
He's so soft spoken too.
He is. He really is. He's like the cutest person I've ever seen in my life.
Oh, thank you. You're cute too.
Oh, shucks.
Your shiny beard.
Yeah, dude.
My beard's beautiful.
I can sing too, by the way.
Yeah, you can.
I'm more of a singer. These guys are just.
I had to break it somehow.
That hurt my self-esteem. I'm offended now.
Let's see, that's what we're offended about today.
That's the worst thing we're offended about. Then we're doing really well, actually.
Yeah, you know those people are offended about
the Starbucks.
Starbucks. Yeah, where did that even come from? Who gets offended by a cup?
No, seriously, how do snowflakes even, you know, coincide with the Christian religion? I don't get it.
Because they're special snowflakes.
You're special.
Wow.
Can we say that? Or
Be nice, Cody.
He's special to me. Like, he's special place in my heart.
Okay. No,
we're dear.
Thank
to
you
each
for
other.
Defining that.
It's
like a bromance.
Bananas are healthy.
Okay, so I do have a question for all five of you now. I'm going to have to rein you five back in here. The first instrument you guys ever played?
Drums.
Drums, okay.
I started out with drums in like third grade, then I stopped playing it, then I started playing guitar, and then that didn't go anywhere.
I can just picture Nick like in third grade with a ukulele. That'd be cool.
I can see him with like his little first act drum sets.
But then I got back into drums around my freshman year of high school.
Okay. Well, you, Cameron?
I started off on the recorder.
The recorder, okay.
A fate worse than hell.
I think that's what everybody started off.
Nope, not me.
I'm not counting the recorders.
Right, not counting the recorders, an acoustic guitar with three strings.
Oh, okay.
Nice.
So, yeah.
Nice. What about you, Kyle? Lean closer to my microphone.
The guitar.
The guitar?
Well,
yeah. All right. Cody?
I was bass.
Bass. All right.
Bass guitar.
Four or six.
I started with a 4. I played a 6 a few times and hated every bit of it. I don't know why I even went for it. I don't know. I guess I wanted to be the dude, like the dude from Korn. But then I realized that I suck. Whatever.
Watch it over there. Watch.
Oh, yeah, we're on camera.
Easy.
I forgot all
Luckily, I think I'm big enough that I'm blocking the view of you.
I completely forgot about the camera. I've been watching my mouth so close that I forgot about that.
That's all right. I do appreciate it.
This has been the longest I think any of us have ever gone without saying the F word.
Yeah.
I told you, this would be hard, dude.
It's a challenge.
I understand that. So, another good question I have for you guys, and I'm actually stealing this one from Jeremiah, who's the general manager. He might be in the conference room, actually. When you guys are playing, I might have Emily go see if he's around. But anyway, where do you guys see yourself in 1 year?
Oh, man.
Not dead.
Well, that's good.
Hopefully with better vision. That'd be pretty cool.
LASIK. Honestly, hopefully see us, we got the EP out, everything, going smoothly. And, we're in talk with a couple of bands on touring, so hopefully something happens with that.
Okay.
We're trying to go on tour within the next year or two.
Okay. And then the same question for 5 years from now.
Still not dead.
We'll be still not dead. Kyle might have a drug problem.
That's not good.
Just look at his face, too. Just like, oh.
That's not cool.
That's bad. Stay in school. Don't do drugs. That's bad.
No drugs. Just kids. Lots of money and groupies.
Knowledge is power.
Hugs, not drugs.
Reading Rainbow was the best show ever.
I don't know, dude. Bob Ross was pretty up there.
Right?
None of this has to do with the next 5 years.
I know.
No, it doesn't. No.
Next 5 years, probably about the same. Just, get at least have an album out. Hey, hopefully have a label under us. A good one.
Okay.
One of the biggest things about trying to get a label is I like to actually be in control of my own music.
Yeah, sure. Exactly. That's 100%. How we all are.
I won't even touch a label if they want me to change anything.
That's pretty much how everybody in this group is right now. Like, we're luckily working with Legion Productions, and they work with us really well, so that's a perk for sure.
That's good.
I tell you what, it's sounding good. I'm really impressed with it.
Spencer's trying to tell me something through the window.
I'm going.
Oh, he's leaving. Oh, okay.
Bye, Spencer.
Bye, Spencer.
Bye,
Spencer. It was good to meet
you,
man.
Nice meeting you, man.
Be safe.
Okay, so.
Be careful out there.
Hey, I've heard you guys play a little preview here. So now I gotta ask you to do a little more.
All right.
You guys wanna try?
More.
Let's see. How about Cameron just do the revenge? Because that is such like that's the little like soft song we have.
The one soft song that we actually.
The one soft song?
The one. I actually sing in this one.
Yeah, it's the only soft song.
You're just, you're singing? You're not screaming it?
Well,
screams a little.
I scream a little.
Okay.
It just depends on how long you want it to run.
It's like 50-50.
You guys play the whole thing if you want.
We'll probably just play the first part, and that's all.
That's fine.
I don't really want to go through the second one again. It's so weird without drums.
That's fine. No, that's fine. That's fine.
Actually.
All right, let's do it. Do it. Do it.
metal, yeah.
Crazy death metals, yeah. Metals.
That was very good, guys. Seriously.
That's the first time.
Wait for it. Wait for it.
Thank you.
Yeah. There we go. There we go.
We haven't heard that in a hot minute. Typically, we just, you know, people are just like, you suck.
Boo! Boo! I'll be honest, my legs ramping up like crazy halfway through that.
God, this water's
so good. If there was one place, both realistic and, yeah, it's never going to happen in my life, that you guys could play, where would it be?
The moon.
Oh, shut up, Cameron.
That'd be a sweet place to
I would say totally whack an open air in Germany.
Yeah, I totally agree with you for
that. That is like the epitome of a death metal festival.
Either that or Download Festival or Sonosphere.
Sonosphere, I mean, Rock Am Ring's pretty good, too.
Something big in Europe, at least.
Yeah, it's got to be like Tusca. Tusca in Finland.
My biggest thing is traveling the world. It's like 50% of why music's my passion is because I want it to take me around the world. Europe is one of my biggest stops.
I really think because, you know, me and Dion are the more Nordic members of the band. I just want to go to Finland.
Norway, Sweden.
Do you have an obsession with Finland, or is it just
being when you're Nordic, you just want to go there? Like
you just
want to
go there and carry a sword and stuff.
Oh, like we're
like a Viking.
We're both Finnish, aren't we?
All day.
I'm Irish.
Oh wow, I thought you were Finnish with me. Yeah, Dan.
Yeah,
Dan.
They're like, good.
Oh, man, that is a story right there.
Yeah, it is.
That
was.
Yeah, yeah.
He ate bull testicles.
I heard that.
So did I.
Yeah, he did too.
We'll save that discussion for another day.
Yeah, she's already heard enough.
Yes,
it was gross.
Cody told me on the way coming in here, to be honest. Oh, man.
I'm really, let's let the record show, I'm really not happy with the direction my life is headed.
Oh, you're sweet.
If you're not happy with the way your life is headed, why are you with these four wackos? I mean, what?
Because they're my brothers, man.
So let me get this straight here. You're unhappy with your life, but they're your brothers, so it's like, you don't even care anymore.
It's like a manipulative relationship.
I see.
That's just
it. I wasn't necessarily voluntarily eating the testicles. That kind of put me in this kind of.
Let's cut that out. Let's cut the.
I'm just so glad he threw you under the bus and not me for that.
Well, all I'm going to say is we'll save that discussion for a whole other day, yeah, or we'll save it for off air. You guys can tell me all about that off air. I have no problem with that. Oh man!
Like I said, so we're probably the scummiest band you've ever had.
That's all right. You guys may call yourself scummy. Sorry, Dean. You guys may call yourself scummy, but you guys are actually being very well behaved compared to some other bands we've had in here.
It's shocking, but we also, like I told you before, you know, we are extremely grateful to be here, and
we appreciate you guys coming out.
The opportunity to do it, so you know, we don't want to mess it up.
Well, you know what? You guys are the worst we've ever had here. You're never coming back. Yeah, I'm just kidding, guys.
Good job, Nick. It was your fault, probably.
Yeah, we drove too long to get kicked out.
Actually, I wasn't going to blame Nick.
I would have.
I was going to blame Dean.
The most soft-spoken one. The best part is the whole ride here. Everybody got all their cuss words out on the road trip.
That's
here.
Good.
Yeah, road rage.
Yeah, I have bad road rage. I was pushing 90 pretty much the whole way.
It was sketchy. We were between like a semi and this wall, and he's like.
And the best part is we're listening to the rough draft of our first song from the EP the whole time, so we're like not only cruising through traffic like 90 miles an hour, but we're also like picking the song apart, like we should add this here or do this here while traveling like 90 miles an hour in between cars.
So basically you're trying to tell me you're going 90 miles an hour between cars and you really didn't care, did you?
All I gotta say is Ryan Dunn is a big influence to me.
Okay. Got it.
We do not condone speeding and stuff like that.
Definitely heavily influenced by Jackass.
We are. I love that show, dude.
Yeah.
That show was actually pretty cool.
Oh, we have a definite plan for our EP release show, which doesn't have its set date yet.
Okay.
But
that's one of the things. He's getting a good segue here. Continue.
Yeah. Well, we don't have it set up just yet. Once we get a little farther into recording, we'll definitely have it up.
Sure.
But,
when's the next gig, guys?
Oh, God. That Like I said, it's being planned.
Yeah, okay. We're mostly focusing on trying to record the EP right now.
Okay, I gotcha.
I do miss playing shows.
The earliest gig we have planned out is possibly in March.
No, no, the EP should be out. It'd be like, yeah, it'd be around like, you know, January, maybe.
January, February?
Okay. Yeah, somewhere around there. But our definite plan is to, you know, before that show, we want to get up there as early as we can because Ryan Dunn is buried in Brecksville.
Oh, okay.
And we want to go visit his grave really bad because, I mean, everyone in this band grew up watching Jackass, so.
Right.
It, you know, what better way to start your, you know, your next run with, you know, chilling with one of your idols? You know, it could be better to be alive, but, you know.
Under better circumstances.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, guys, it looks like Dean has something very profound he wants to say.
Oh, God.
Oh, no, I'm just eager.
Oh. Oh,
all right, guys, I'm actually going to go ahead and have us take a commercial break real quick.
All right, with you guys?
Good
to me. Yes.
All right, we'll be right back here. Livestream.com/LakeEffect and, of course, Breakers. Be back in a few minutes.
Woo!
It's a local music spotlight on Lake Effect Radio. Melanie May, We Relive Last Night.
Do this. Matter of fact, I must know this about being alone with you. I knew what you were thinking. Yeah, I was thinking it too. Our feelings were bound to surface, and I don't really regret it. I hope you don't either. Oh, you were making me sweat. Let's do it again. I wanna relive last night. Find myself in your right.
Be sure to watch us live on www.livestream.com/LakeEffect.
in my head, think I'm schizophrenic. Where they saying they get it from another planet. 36,000 times, do a somersault. Do it right and you can live your whole summer off. I'm on my mind, yeah, seeing double, y'all. Tell me what's the chance of just a f*** over, y'all. She said, as long as we can do it with your eyes on. If that decay, we might well need a light zone. Just blew 1,000 Swiss sweets. In my black and orange charger, call it trick or treat. It ain't nothing to a fuck, my goons got goons. How stupid, dumb, big, my rooms got rooms. Why y'all trip? I'm just fine. 12:45, about that time. Been dead it all week, time to unwind. Train like a tank, blew my mind. This is crazy, way too bad. Bring the whole city out. Doing what I do best, deep boy stuntin'. New car, old money, deep boy stuntin'. Step in cleaner than a new 40. My nickname in the eight, strapped up, shouted. You know my nerve bad, trigger like a two-pin. Line riding around the corner, boy, too thin. T-Code, black shades on my black chains. And if you wouldn't understand, it's a black thing. You know we drink that rosé until we black out.
We have loose interpretation of the rules. Is that what I heard, Dean?
That was me.
That's
my outlook on things.
So, we have made history on this show today, I think. It's the first time I've ever interviewed somebody who's a screamer. And I do have some questions for you on that. But first, we're going to jump to Cameron. Because for the first time, I think, ever, Cameron, you were telling us off the air something about yourself. It's astounding to me, you know? It really is. Go ahead and tell everybody real quick, if you don't mind.
Well, in very simple terms, I'm blind as crap. But it was actually a really interesting story. I was originally born, and the doctors went in and told my parents, right off the bat, you know, Cameron's never going to see anything other than light or dark, you know, not even shadows, just if something's bright or if it's not, and that's all I'd be able to see. Because I was born with congenital cataracts, so both of the lenses in my eyes were about as see-through of these walls. Okay. So I think before I was even a few months old, they had to cut open my eyes and take the lenses out, and I have had plenty of surgeries, plenty of exams where they actually have to cut open my eye and look inside and see what's going on.
That's metal.
And you can actually see by looking at them how my eyes are a lot smaller than...
Yeah, I was...
It's... bilateral microphthalmia, something like that. It's just, there's so many things wrong with my eyes. Like, I got glaucoma. But I mean, I make it work. I can still jam and I see pretty good. I mean, and I had to go to a special doctor to get my license, but I'm getting my license, so I can
see good
enough to do that.
It really impressed us the most when he first came to the band and started writing the things he started writing. Like, you know, not only is he not familiar with the style we're doing, mm-hmm. but, you know, he just cranked it out like it was nothing, and then I'm just like, I felt like, you know, really mean, kind of like a jerk, because I looked at him like, you know, third day of practice, I'm like, dude, are you wearing contacts with your eyes, man?
Dude, you wouldn't believe how many times, like, per day I get asked if I'm wearing contacts.
Yeah, and he tells me he's completely blind. I'm like, you're blind and you're throwing out riffs like that, dude. Like,
it really is amazing, Cameron.
It blew us away, man. That's, you know, he's our little blind kid. We love him.
Thanks, man.
I love you, buddy. Too. Even though your girlfriend's really mean to us.
Me too, man.
I hope she's not listening.
I think she's at
work. We're going to get a message here in about 5 minutes. I heard that.
I think she's at work. Thank God.
No, but Cameron, seriously, that would be inspirational to a lot of people when you think about it, man. You with what you've had to go through, you know,
it's been a hell of a ride, man. But I make it work, and you learn to deal with it.
And that's what we need more of that in this world. I think people just want to strive to be their best, no matter what they may be dealing with. So now we're gonna change gears, Dean. Your turn.
What's up?
As I mentioned before, you were the first screamer I've ever interviewed.
Yes, sir.
The first question I want to ask is, how in the world can you scream and not completely kill your vocal cords?
It's metal, simplistically put, is all technique.
Okay.
Headbanging is technique. Otherwise, you're going to throw your back out, hurt your neck, you know, same thing with screaming. You don't actually scream. You're not, like, being pissed off and, you know. It's all from your diaphragm. You know, I mean, I use my nose and my technique, and I do a lot of different things, and some people, everybody has, like, their own little technique that they work
sure.
on. I've never had lessons with anything, singing or screaming, so I just kind of worked at it until eventually I built a technique that didn't hurt me, made it to where I could still sing very clearly, and, you know, I don't want to damage my vocal cords. I'm definitely more of a singer than a screamer, but I love these guys and I love the music that we're making in this band, so.
Okay, good.
Absolutely.
Yeah, because I heard you singing. Was that Revenge you guys were doing earlier?
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard you singing Revenge. I'm like, dude, he's got a voice.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, sir.
He can do Judas Priest stuff.
I love power metal. I can do anything. I'm a blues man. I like to sing the blues.
Okay.
You know, rock, anything. I love Tool. Yeah.
That's not appropriate with the blues, kind of.
Boom, 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 boom.
Ba-dum-bum. I was trying to find an appropriate button, but I couldn't find one. So, oh well.
But,
so, go ahead. No, you go ahead, dude.
But yeah, screaming, it's all from your diaphragm. You don't actually scream, otherwise you will hurt yourself.
Yeah.
If you're a singer, you know, by far, I would say definitely stick with singing. But if you do want to scream, find a technique. Don't just be pissed off and yell into the mic as loud as you can.
Okay. 'Cause
I've heard a lot of vocalists in the scene that just don't scream right. And you can tell, like, by the end of the show, they start not being able to really talk very well. Starts damaging their voice. It's dangerous, but, you
That's
know,
how
it's
you
a passion.
People like Ollie Sykes.
Play a dangerous game.
I've always said if passion, you know, if music wasn't a passion that made my life worth living,
right,
I wouldn't do it. It wouldn't
right.
be worth it. It's I throw all my money at it. You know, I drive miles out, basically wasting money to go play shows for people who sometimes, you know, really don't care.
Right.
Yeah,
you know, and then you come back. So, you know, it's something that helps me make it day to day. It's my thing. It's my passion.
I have to say, Nick, Kyle, you two are being way too quiet. That's not allowed.
Yeah, speak
That's
up.
That's because we have a list of stuff we can't say on the
radio. That's about the whole reason.
I knew that was going. I knew that was going to come up here before we ended up finishing here. Well, guys, we really do appreciate you guys coming out. Sorry,
thanks for having us, man.
Ran a little shorter than expected today. Well, when you guys come back in the spring, we'll definitely have you a lot longer, hopefully.
Right on, man.
Awesome. All right, we're going to go ahead and wrap up for today. And see here. I'm going to go one more time. Cody, Kyle, Cameron, Dean, Nick. Hi, Emily. And Spencer was here for about 2 minutes. Tim, signing off. We will catch you guys in a few minutes with Michael McFarland. Do I have something you want to say real quick, Dean?
Is there any way we could show him the recording we have?
Yeah, we could get you guys have that real quick.
Yeah, actually,
we're gonna be playing a song from that Indians Wear Moccasins wrote as we leave.
It's still in the editing and mastering process. There's no vocals to it, so it's strictly instrumental. But hope you enjoy it. It's a taste of what we as a full band can do.
And you can see what the synth is sounding like since we couldn't.
Yeah, because Kyle's actually our keyboard player. Cameron guitar, vocals, drums, other guitar.
All right, cool. All
right.
I will take the phone for just a second so I can get it rolling here. And as soon as I turn the mics off, we'll be ready to roll with the song here. Anything you guys want to say real quick before we get going?
Yeah, thank you guys very much for having us on here. It's been a really, really good time. And thank you guys out there for listening.
Stay metal.
Like us on Facebook at Indians Wear Moccasins.
Yeah.
There we go. Twitter?
No.
So I'm going to have you guys come over here and tell me where the recording is, because I'm not sure where it is exactly.
All right.
Cameron, don't hurt yourself.
I don't tell me how to live my life,
baby. Uh-oh, did we just have a don't tell me how to live my life phrase?
No, we do it a lot.
Go over to the messenger.
All right, we're going to go ahead and get going, guys. Have a good night, and we will catch you guys in a few minutes.
Peace!
Be sure to watch us live on www.livestream.com/lakeeffect.
Text in to 440-940-6615 to request songs.